Good morning, I'm Dilip Thakur, editor of Education Group.
Good morning, I'm Sumia Yasmin, managing editor.
During the past 2 months, during the second wave of the pandemic, Education World has been coming out regularly, and we have been focusing on higher education. In the month of May, we produced our Education World India higher education rankings, focusing on arts, science and commerce colleges, undergraduate colleges, and further divided into private autonomous, government autonomous, non-autonomous, top 100 engineering colleges, and also ranking them in states and according to parameters. Very extensive study, survey, for which we, our partners, that's the Delhi-based company, Market Research and Opinion Polls Company, C4, interviewed almost 5,000 people.
Over 6,000 people
across the country to rate and rank India's best undergraduate institutions.
In our June issue, we beamed the spotlight on India's top 300 universities, private universities, government universities, as well as India's top 100 private B schools. And this year, for the first time, we also introduced top 10 institutes for top 10 undergrad courses, where we covered very popular courses such as B in architecture, B in data science, B in computer science, etc. And again, this survey was conducted by Center for Forecasting and Research, which interviewed over 4,000 final year students of colleges, university faculty, as well as industry representatives.
Yes, and that's all in our very latest issue. That's this issue, the June issue.
Yes.
And I think it's in the interest of our readers for us to tell them exactly, perhaps in greater detail, that what's inside this unique magazine, perhaps globally unique magazine, and the pains that we've taken to convey.
In fact, the EW India Higher Education rankings are very comprehensive in both the issues put together. Over 1,000 of India's best higher education institutions have been ranked and assessed across a wide range of parameters, including competence of faculty, research and innovation, placements, admission criteria, etc.
A total of 14 parameters.
Yes. And I think it's very important for students as well as parents, school-leaving students, to go through and understand these rankings, particularly since all board exams, class 12 board exams have been cancelled and there's a lot of apprehension and anxiety among students. So if you read our rankings and peruse them very closely, you'll be able to, it'll help you and enable you to make optimal higher education choices according to your budgets, according to your aptitudes and talents.
And aspirations.
Yes.
So we highly recommend, we've left out the IIMs because they routinely tap.
Yeah. And the IITs among
and
engineering
the
colleges. We
yes.
Let them out because they admit only about 5% of the people who write their IIT JEE exams.
So in the latest issue, we have, of course, our editorial page where we talk about macro issues like why is India not is a laggard in education compared to the rest of the world. And there's an editorial on the farmers issue.
Very important, I think, the farmers
where,
completed.
Which is going on and now has completely disappeared from the media headlines, though the farmers have been for over 6 months camped outside Delhi.
Yes.
Then, as usual, we have our education news pages where we provide news from various states, for example, from Delhi, Maharashtra,
Karnataka,
West Bengal,
Tamil Nadu,
and Madhya Pradesh.
Yes. In both our issues, May and June issues, we have some very excellent columns. In the June issue, Dr. Krishna Kumar, former director of NCERT, has addressed a very important issue as to the revival and repair of K-12 education in
after COVID
in the COVID pandemic.
How to pick up the pieces of you know, the shattered education system.
And I think Dr. Amrinder Sahu, he also has addressed a very important issue of how to build capacity in higher education, especially faculty.
Which are the colleges which are the most popular for providing these courses?
Yes.
So it's a very useful guide to students, school leavers.
Absolutely. And we also have a very interesting interview with Mr. Dinesh Verma, who's one of India's most well-known architects. Especially for education institutions. He shares very interesting insights on what makes education institutions welcome and attractive places for students to study.
No, and how important it is to make education institutions attractive and welcoming, as opposed to the government thinking of creating just like square boxes and utilitarian schools, which look more like prisons than schools.
Yeah. And in our postscript page, of course, we have very interesting postscripts. And this time we paid a special tribute of Education World to a great education leader and institution builder, Dr. Bijaya Sahu, who unfortunately passed away because of COVID complications last month.
Yes. Dr. Sahu, from the turn of the century, when he started, new millennium, when he started his first school, has done a remarkable job in impacting the backward state of, formerly backward state of Odisha, onto the education map of India. And his Sai International School, which started in the year 2006, and it was incidentally fully committed to the parameters by which you measure excellent institutions, devised by Education World, transformed that school into India's number one day-come boarding school in the year 2021.
Yes, 2021.
Yes. So it was it's a great tribute to him. And of course, then there is our fulminations against various people we think we don't like on this page of the postscript. So all in all, it's a fully very comprehensive issue, which we strongly recommend. When we recommend that you read both these together, so that you get a comprehensive view of which are India's best higher education institutions.
Yes, and before we go, as usual, our Parents World, May and June issues. May issue, we did a very, very important story on how parents can enable children to cope with pandemic anxiety. And in our June issue, we have thrown the spotlight on how parents can protect children from divorce trauma.
Here it is. That's how Parents Work June issue.
Yes.
So that's all from us. Thank you.
Thank you. Stay safe and healthy.